So,
you will also send us the recording.
Yes, I can. Yes, yes, I can do that. Yes, I can do that. Okay. So let us start with the banner.
Okay.
So to change the banner, to change anything on the content, we have to. I need to log in with the admin user. Okay, so let's suppose that we have to change this banner, or we have to add a banner, or we have to update a banner. For that, we will click on content on the top of the menu.
Sorry, hang on. Sorry, we lost your voice in between. We can over again.
Okay. So I'm saying that to change the content, I will log in with admin, and I logged in with admin. Now I'm already logged in with admin. Now to change the banner of the site, or to update anything in the banner, we have to go into content on the top menu. I will click on this. Under the type, I will select rotator and click on filter. Now all these three banners.
We go on to content, and under that we find out rotator.
Yes, you go to content. Let me do this again.
Okay.
To go to content, under the type drop down, you need to select rotator. Okay. Click on filter button. Now these are the three banners that are already uploaded on the site. Now let's suppose that we have to add a new banner. For that, I will click on add content.
Okay.
Under add content, I will select rotator.
Mm-hmm.
Now I will give the title. This title will become the title of the banner. Let's say green. And I will enter the caption. The caption of the image will be entered into the body.
So this caption, we can also
As in automatically pick an as in like Vic? I did not get your point.
So if you look at our website, maybe what you could do is one is you can open this is the scaling site. You can also open the website.
Okay.
Which we can, record.
Yeah. So this is the website production site. So I've opened the production site, Vivek. Hello, Vivek.
The standards and guidance for training. Okay, if you stop this banner there, if you keep your mouse there.
Sure.
No. Go to the rotator again.
Yeah, I'm on the rotator. Yeah.
So now if you could keep your mouse on the banner, the images would not move, right?
Yeah, right. Yes. Right, Vivek.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, okay. So, if you look at this text,
are you talking about the caption text?
The 40 text, yeah. This text is being picked up from the internal pages, right?
No, I mean like you need to enter this here, in this body.
Okay, so we need to enter it where it's not picked up from any of the internal pages.
Yes. It will not pick up from any of the internal pages, but you can link this banner to any of the internal pages.
Okay.
Okay, so I will enter the caption in this body. Now I will upload a banner image.
Okay.
I will select an image, let's say select this one. So I mean like I have mentioned the best size, that what should be the best size for a banner in a training guide. So the image which I am uploading now may not be of the best size. Okay, and here in the title field, I will enter the title of the button. So like when what you see in a banner, a button, like right now it's learn more, so they can also, you know, write a text for this button. And I can enter a URL of the page where I want to link when user will click on the learn more. So let's say I want to link it, like I can to link to any other sites. Let's say I want to link it to wri.org. Copy, and I will enter the URL. And I will click on save. Now if I go onto the banner, the home page.
Okay.
So you can see the banner is now appearing, and the text that I entered is also appearing, right?
Now, when I was doing this, on my own, the image what I uploaded, you know, was probably different in the size. So only half of that image was coming in and it was being expanded and something like that. So do you have any recommendations?
Yes.
Yes,
Vivek, we have a recommendation, and I have mentioned that recommendation in the manual, right? So maybe I can, you know, update that manual and send that to you again.
Okay.
Now if I click on learn more, I will be taken onto the page of whose URL I entered while creating the banner.
Sure. Very well that, so all the images.
Hello?
We uploaded here, right? There is an option to do it on this page.
Vivek, I lost you in between. Can you repeat what you said?
I was asking the images that will be coming up on the rotator or on the banner. We will have to convert them into the recommended size first.
Yeah.
And then select and then upload them here, right? We can't do it online on this page, right? On the editing menu.
Yes, I mean like you can upload it, but then it will not look good. But the recommended size is very general size, so you can like, you know, find that image very easily. Right? Hello?
Yes, can
we
hear that? Yeah, that's okay.
Can we do a call on phone, and maybe like we can continue sharing the screen on GoToMeeting, but we can do a call on phone, I think, but because there is a problem with the connection.
Can I call your cell phone?
Maybe you can call or I can call you back.
I'll call you back.
Okay. I move ahead now?
Yeah.
Okay. Now coming down, we have this text of about GNG program and about us. So if user wants to change this, for that he has to go into content and because about us content is already added, so we can go and edit that, right? So I will just, now while after going into the content, I will select the type as basic page, site pages. I will select site page as a type and click on filter. And in this, I will found about. I will and click on edit. I will find about in the list and click on edit. So if user wants to change any content, update, he can do it from here. Like he can also change the body, he can also change the title of about, and he can also change the body of this text.
So this is the about page, right? About page.
Yeah, right. Yes, I mean like we are taking around 150 to 200 characters of this whole page and showing it on the home page.
Okay.
Okay, so it can be done from this page, right?
Suppose if we do not want to link it and if we want to have a separate, there will be a coding required or we can do it here?
I think there will be bit of coding will be required. And once the code is open, you can do it from there. So, you know, like, you know, this is the body of the about, and we have a CK editor enabled over here. So, CK editor can be used for doing the formatting as well. So, like, I can, you know, if I want to bold any text, I can click, select that text, I can click on bold to bold it. I can make it italic, just like the bold, like word formatting, underline it. And if I want to, let's say if I want to make give any text a heading 2 or 3, that can be done. So let's suppose that if I want to give history a heading,
okay,
heading 2, I think right now it's heading 3 or 2, right now it's heading 2, like let's suppose I want to make it as heading 3, then I will select this drop down and select the heading to which I want to assign it. So you can see it now gone. I won't make it heading. Okay. Yeah. Now it's heading 1. This is now let's suppose that you want to link a page to a separate page. Like you want to put some text which can be linked to some other site, that can also be done. So let's say that if I want to yes, yes, that is possible. So let me do that. I will select a text. Let's say I want to link this one. I will select this one and I will click on this icon, the link icon. I will enter the page to whom I want to, where I want to link it. Let's suppose I want to link this URL to indiagng.org.
Yeah.
So I was saying that if I want to link something, so I have selected history, and let's say I want to link this history text to a third party site. Let's say I want to link it to WRI site. I will click on I will enter the URL WRI.org. Click on OK, and I will click on the save button to save this information. Okay, so here I link the history wri.org. Now if I click on history, it will take me to a wri.org site. Okay. Now let's say like if I editor can also be used for embedding the image. So let's say that we might have a requirement, we want to display some images in a body text. That can also be done. So let's say like if I want to insert an image below this paragraph, I will click on this image icon. I will click on browse server. Sure, I think we can, let me find out if we have that in a tool. Otherwise I can enable that option, because it provides this editor provides the option for changing the font colors. Let me see if that option is enabled right now. I think that option is not enabled in this editor. I can get this enabled and let you know. Will that be okay? I was saying that in this CK editor we don't have the option of changing the font color and types, but I can get that option enabled into this editor and let you know. Okay, I will do that. Now let's say that if I want to enter an image, I will click on image icon. Well, you can enter the image anytime, but then you have to drag that image to put it at that position. So it's better that you put your cursor at a position where you want to insert an image. So I put in my cursor at this position. I will click on image icon. Click on browse server. I can either select an image from any of these, which is all. So let's suppose I want to insert this image. I will select an image and I will double click it. I will have the option of entering the size of that image, like which size I need to show. So let's suppose that I want to show a size of because this this image is coming into the body text of a page, so it can be it is something that has to be designed by the user, that what at like which size he should display on that page. So sometimes he might want to display a big image on a page, so he can like select a big size, and sometimes he wants to like show small image like we have on a listing page, then he can select that size. So I think it needs to be designed by the user who is like entering that image at that time, that what is his requirement, what type of size that he wants to show. Yes, you can always do that. Yes, just so right. Yes, it is possible. So let's suppose that if I want to update the size of this image which I have entered now, or what I just need to do is that I just need to double click on this image and this pop-up will again open and I can change the size. So I'm entering a smaller one actually. I can also set the alignment of this image, like whether I want to put it in the left or the right. And I will click on save and this image will appear on that page. Yes, this is possible. Yes. So let me show you that also. So let's suppose that if you want to have a gap, what you just need to do is that you just need to click on spacebar. So you can see, I think still let me give me more time. Yeah, I'm like to give the spacing. I think user can always give a spacing, but right now I think I'm not able to give the proper spacing. That is like that's the reason it is coming onto the legs line. I will get back to you on this. So that was about using the capability of editor and changing the formatting of the page. Now let's go back onto the home page and move to the next section. Now we have these three blocks, and let's suppose that you want to change the text for this block. What you need to do is that you need to hover on that block, and you will see a drop arrow. You just need to click on that arrow. A link of configure block will appear. Once you click on that, same thing, you will see a page with a title and a description. So whatever you want to put in that box, you can enter that text into this body field. And like if you want to link that block to any specific page, you can select that text and link it to that page. Right now we have linked it to the standard and guidance page. Yeah, I mean just you need to the way I showed you before, you need to select that text, click on that link title and enter the URL of the page where you want to link it. I'm sorry? Yes, the reason it is colored because I have linked it, because it is now a link. So link is shown in that blue color. I can save. So you can do the same for the other two blocks as well. Yeah, right. Now for editing this video, now we can see a video, and let's say that I want to change a video. I will click on configure block. You can see a video appearing over here. Let me delete this video, and I will show that how you can enter a video. So I deleted this video. Now for entering a video, what you need to do is that you need to click on flash and you need to enter a URL from any of the sites. So let's say I want to take a video from YouTube. Wait, how can I search that video? What if I want to search that GNG video, what should I enter? Okay. Okay, so this is the video. What I just need to do is that, yeah, you need to copy the URL. And you can enter a URL in this URL field.
Okay.
You can
just copy the URL.
No, when you are when you are like putting it in an editor, then you don't need to use the embed code. Yeah, and because I copied this video from YouTube, and let's suppose that you have a video on your desktop, then you can also upload that. For doing that, you need. I'm sorry, Vic, go ahead.
What was video format?
Yeah, let's see. If I click on browse, I think it's MP4. What I will do is that I will write the video format that can be uploaded, and I will update that into the manual and send that to you, right? So let's suppose that if you have video, no, there is no restriction on the size of the video, but there is no restriction on the size of a video, but we prefer that the video should not be of very very huge size, because then it will like only increase some load on the server. But there is no restriction. Sure, I will do that. Now I can. So I like copied the URL from YouTube. I can also define the width and height of the video. So it's like 400. Let's say 400. I click on OK. I will click on save. Video should appear over here. Video should appear over here, but it's not appearing. Just give me 2 minutes, I check.
Okay, so the video.
Yeah, it's not coming. Let me just check why it's not coming. So let's suppose that I want to put this content on the page. Because I'm copying it from any web tool, so what that web tool might have his own formatting. So what I will do is that to undo that formatting, I will copy it into the notepad first, and then I will copy it from a notepad and I will paste it into the editor. Now, so hello, sorry, Vic. Vic, is it Yes, I mean like if you just do the direct paste from a Word or from any online tool, what happens is that tool, contains their own formatting. So like they might have their own p tags or something like that, which has their own internet formatting going on. So what when we like to directly copy it from there and paste it into this editor, those formatting get lost. So you know, to undo those formatting of those online tools, what we generally do is that we copy that text into first into Notepad, because what Notepad does is that it undo all the formattings for whatever tool you are copying it. Then we paste it into the editor. So that is the best way of doing it.
Okay.
Vivek, is it possible if you give me a call on Priyanka's number? I think there's a problem with my phone. Okay, what if you need to maintain the formatting? Well, you can do the formatting in an editor. So if you know that what formatting, but then it should be like do redoing the things, right? Let me check that one, that if you want to maintain that same formatting while copying it, well, then what we need to do, I'll get back to you on that one as well. Now I have pasted this text. Let's suppose if I want to mark it as featured, I will select featured content checkbox. Then from paste type, I will select whether it is whatever what type of content I am creating, whether it's standard guidance, videos, news, press release, publications, trainings, or events. Let's say this is an event. I select event, and as soon as I will select event, two fields of dates will appear, from date and to date. So I will select the date when the event is going to happen. So I selected, let's say the event is going to happen on 18th to 19th Jan. I can enter a time. I will enter the organizer's name. I will enter its address. I can also choose an image for that event if I have one. It's not a compulsory field, but if I have one, I can choose that. I will upload an image. Let's suppose that, you know, after the event has gone by, and if I want to upload any attachment related to that event, any training material, I can also do that. Yes. You can also upload the PDF document, Word document, if you have any. Okay, I think we have not included the docs. Okay, we will include the docs format here as well, and then docs will be also included. I don't have any PDF right now, I think I don't have any PDF.
Okay.
I think that one is fixed. That one is fixed. Acha, on a featured content. So are you talking about the featured content or the page where the events are listed? Yeah. Okay.
The order of shifting of the event.
Okay. So what you can do is that you can, you know, mark the event which is, you know, coming first, because I think the order in which they are appearing now is descending order, right? So let's suppose that if you want to show this further event on the top, then you need to first mark the March event as featured, and then after that you can do for February event. So like it's February.
So is that the only way out?
No, I mean like if I can. Yes, I can do that. Okay, I can do that. Okay, I will do that. Okay, so I uploaded the image. Now I will click on save. I will go into the home page. So this is the event which I created, right? And I mark it as featured, so it is appearing on this featured block. And if I go into the event page, I don't know. So this is the event that I created, and here the events are listed in a proper order. So the one which is like going to happen first will appear on the first on the list. So we have two sections, upcoming events, and then we have another section of past events. So the event in which the date has already been passed has moved into past event, and the dates which are like the event which are coming up is in the upcoming event section, right? So we have January, and then we have like we have 18 January first, and then we have 22nd January 2014. Yeah. Now let's move on to the next section, that is on new blog. So for creating the blog, you need to follow the same steps. Like you click on content, click on add content. Click on blog, and you can enter the text for that blog here. If I want to mark this blog as featured, I will click on feature. If I want to upload an image for the blog, I can also do that. Then we have a field of captions. So let's suppose that if there is any image in a blog and you want to put up caption for that image, like, you know, which tells that what this image is all about, then you can enter that caption in this caption field. And if I also want to like mark the credit for that image, let's suppose that if I know that this image is like is taken from a WRI site, and if I want to put a credit on this image, I can also do that. So let's suppose that if I put a credit as WRI, then it will appear, and I'm onto this feature. Now if I click on save, so this is the blog that I created, and I marked it as featured, so it is appearing in the featured blog.
Okay.
And clicking on this will take me to a detail page of that blog. So you can see. See, this is the caption which I entered, this is the credit which I entered, this is the text that I copied. And if I want to see the listing view of the blog, I need to go into resources, click on blog, and the blog that I entered will see appearing over here. Right? Now let's move ahead to the next point. Now we have news also, and if you want. Yeah, I mean like this is also. Yeah, right. Okay. For creating a news, we have to do the same step of going into content. And if you click on add content, you will. If you click on add content and then click on site pages, you can enter the title, body of a news. And if you want to mark this news as a feature, you need to click on feature. And if you want, like you are creating a news, so you will, from page type, you will select this as news. Right, it is under media center page, right. Press release section. Yeah. So, and it will start appearing on that. Now let's suppose that if you want to edit any news, then you need to go into content, site pages, and then you can search for the news that you want to edit, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now going back onto the home page. We have a footer section where we are entering the contact information, and let's suppose I want to change the contact. I will hover on that block, I will see a drop down arrow. I will click on that arrow, a link of configure block will appear. I will click on that, and the section of contact us will appear. And let's suppose if I want to put that those details. And what information? Right, I'm doing it on a staging side. I don't want to do anything on production right now. So I can change the title, whatever title I want to show in that section. So I can do that. I will click on save. And that information will start appearing over here. Then we have Twitter updates. So we are showing a Twitter from an account whose account is configured over here. And if I want to change that setting, that account, what I need to do is that I need to hover on that block. I will see a drop down. I will click on that arrow and configure link. It will take me to a page. I just need to enter the widget ID of that account, of whose tweet I need to fetch, right? So I can enter that ID and his tweets will be fetched and shown on that block. That height and width is, I think, yeah, that can be configured. I think yes. So let me try. I'm sorry. No, from here only. Let me just try. I'm trying that. So let me see if I try to increase it to 600.
Right now, the block
So let me just try to do this. Let me break. See how this comes. Yes, you can reduce the height and width also from there, from here on. Now to the next menu of about. So I showed you that how can you. Yeah. What? Yeah. Yes.
The last line is even three.
Yeah.
So if I take any different time there, it would also reflect on my Twitter timeline, right?
Yes. What happens is that when you click on that box, it automatically takes you to a Twitter page. And let's say whatever I write, it will show it on your wall.
Alright, so this was one. Second one was that we also had other social media accounts, like Flickr, and maybe Photodesk and something. We can have Flickr also on that tag. And Facebook. I'm not sure LinkedIn is possible, so LinkedIn is a very close.
I need to check that.
Yes.
I will check for Flickr and I will let you know. So I think Flickr does provide that capability that we can embed that those things. So I will check that for Flickr. Okay. Alright, so let me move on to the next menu of about. For that, Karishma, I will get that then, because I think like we need to make some changes into the code, because what happens right now is that when you then clicks on Facebook,
yes,
he's taken onto a page where he can share the site on Facebook. So if I log in with my, I can share just two things, like one is Facebook like and one is Facebook share. So right now we are putting Facebook share. So like when I use a click on Facebook, it takes him to a Facebook and it can share this site with his on his wall.
Okay.
And what you said is that
there is some recommendation from our DC office.
Yeah.
In the bottom most section.
Yeah.
We have Twitter and Facebook. Maybe we could have a Facebook like angle there.
Yes.
Internally, we have Facebook share model.
Yes.
Is that possible?
So Facebook share and like both, you are saying, right?
Yes.
Yes, I think that is possible. Yeah, we can write that cluster. Yeah. Okay. So I mean, Krishna, I need to make some changes into the code for that, because right now. Yeah, I can. Yeah, I mean. Right, that's true, and that is the reason why I'm saying that there are two visits in a Facebook. One is Facebook share, and one is Facebook like. So in a Facebook like, when you click on a Facebook, it takes to a page where you want to, where you can like take to a face. Like let's say, if I want to take a user onto a JG Facebook page, then I can do that with a Facebook like. With a Facebook share, what happens is that if I click on Facebook share, it takes me to my own Facebook account, and then I can share that that site with my on my wall, right? So
can I
yes. Yes, yes, yes. That's what I'm saying, that we need to make some changes. I will get that done. Yeah. Okay. Now moving on to the next menu, we have about. So I told you that how you can edit those static page. Edit the about us page, and the rest of the pages on this section are static pages. So let's say that they are providing program overview, and if you will come onto the program overview page, you will see an edit link. And when you will edit them, you can edit the page similarly as what I have told you about the about us page, right? And let's say if you want to make a new menu, let's say we have 5 subsections into this about. If I want to add a new subsection into that, for that I need to follow our steps for creating a new menu, and I will tell you I will show you how to do that. I will go into structure. In a structure, I will click on menus. I will click on main menu and list links. I will click on list links for a main menu. Now here I will see how all the menus are listed. Now let's suppose that if I want to add a menu into about, under about, for that I will need to click on add link. I will enter a name of that menu, that subsection. I will enter a path. Let's suppose if I want to enter this menu under so I can enter any I can enter a path which I don't use. And now I will select to under whose which menu I need to show this one. So I will select about. The about I need to add this one. So click on update. I will click on update, and I can also select a weight. So let's suppose that if I want to show this menu on the top of on the top of those subsections, the first subsection, then I will select a weight as minus. I will click on save. So this menu got created. Now if I go into, and I can also change order of that menu from here also. Let's suppose that if I want to put it at the first place, I will just drag it and put it above the overview, program overview, and click on save. Now I will go into the home. About, so you can see I created this one, it's appearing now, and I can enter the text for this section by clicking on the edit button, right? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Similarly, I can do the same thing for all of these static pages. Now I will move into standard and guidance. Yeah.
Sure.
right?
Yes, you can do it. You just need to go. Yeah. Okay. So you are saying that you want to add new main menu, right? So they are like, there are these tabs and you want to add one more tab into it, right?
Yes.
I show you how you can do it. You need to go to structure. Just click on menu. Yeah, but when you like when you creating a new tab, at that time you don't need to select a parent because it is a main menu, right? It is a new tab. It does not have any parent, so you do not need to select any parent at that time. Okay. Now coming to the standard guidance. Okay. Now, let's suppose that if I want to add a new standard guidance, I will follow the same steps of going into content, add content, site pages, and then I will select. I will follow the same step which I did for news and blogs, and under page type, I will select standard guidance. Yeah, and rest of them, those steps will remain the same. Okay, and these are the static pages. Below that, like explaining scope 1, 2, 3, corporate standard, these are all static pages. So you need to follow the same steps which I did for the about us page. Right? Now, moving on to the calculation tools. So this one is a static page. The first page is static page. And if you want to edit a content, you can click on edit link and you can edit the content of this page. For spectrally tool set, this is again this spectrally tool set page is a standard like static page, and if you want to edit a content, you can do the same by clicking on edit. Now if I go into any particular industry, let's say if I click on aluminium, now I need to click create a calculation tool. For creating a calculation tool, I will go into content, click on add content, select calculation tools, I will create a new calculation tool. Now I will select that this calculation tool will fall under which sector. So I have these sectors. Let's suppose I want to create a calculation tool under aluminium. I will select aluminium. I will upload a file for that calculation tool. To search for a PDF, but what you need to do is that you need to upload that file. You click on save. And that calculation tool will start up again under that sector. So if I go and I created a calculation tool under aluminium, I click on aluminium, you can see that page coming. Okay, so I need to make some changes. So I need to give a link, the link for this page. I will copy a link. Okay. So I created a calculation tool for aluminium. Now I have to link that page with this link, so that when user click on aluminium, it should be taken onto the page which I just created. So for that, I will select that text. I will click on the link icon. I will enter the path. Click on save. Now if I click on aluminium now, I will be taken onto a page which I just created, right? Hello?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. This was about calculation tool. Now I will go into resources. Yeah, like I created the calculation. Now if you can all, the admin user can also view the calculation tools which has been uploaded by the member companies. For doing that, you will click on the view calculation tools. And you will be taken onto a page where all the calculation tools updated by the member companies are shown. So the name of a calculation tool, the category under which it has been uploaded, and the calculation tool which has, the actual calculation tool which has been uploaded. Okay. Now I will move it to resources. The resource specific page is a static page and it can be edited by the same step which I just told you. I will go into video and expert page talks. So these are the video and expert which has been created. Now let's suppose if user wants to create a new one, he will go into content. We'll click on add content, site pages. You will enter the title of a video. You will enter the text for that video. Select a page type as video. And now he will enter the video URL in this field. So let's suppose I have this video. I will enter its URL in this field. I can enter a caption for this video. I will enter a credit, like from where the video has been taken up. So let's say I took it from the GAG protocol side. Now I will click on save. You can see this is the video which I uploaded. And if I click on this one, I will be taken onto the detail page where the video review will be shown with the text which I just entered. Okay, shall I move to the next training materials?
Yeah.
not training material, they are again listed. And if you want to create a new training material, you need to follow the same steps of going into content. Adding a content, site pages, and entering the title, cap, the body, and from a page type you can select as training. And once you will create and save that, that training will start appearing on this page. Same for the publications, you need to follow the same steps which I told you about training and videos. The same steps will appear for the publications. But I think now publication has been removed from the production site, so they will not appear now. Now for blog post. Authoring information. Shall I edit it? Okay. Let me go to a blog post. Okay, let me just go to the blog post. And I edit it, right? Yeah. Okay. Now where should I go? Okay. Yep. So this authoring information is the name of the user who has authored it. So let's suppose if you want to put any other user's name, then that can also appear. Let's suppose that if I want to put a name of a user, by default it is by admin because admin is creating them. But if I want to change the authoring information and if I want to put some other user's name who is a user, who is a member of this site, then I can select that name. Yes, but I think we can create a separate field for that, and the name of the user, whatever you will enter there, can appear. So I think we can work on that as well. Okay. Yes. For that, Vivek, I think we need to create a separate field, and I can get that created. Hello? Yeah. Hello?
Yeah. Okay.
Yes. I think yes, we can include this item in as the next phase of development. I think that can be done. So if you want to enable a comment setting, so by default they are open. Let's suppose that if you want to I think it doesn't matter. Okay. Okay. Now you will click on save. So let's see that I think it will pick up a name of that user. Yes, it picked up the user. But the point is just, I think that you are making a valid point. Right now it's just taking up the name of the users who are registered. So this is about the blog and other pages, and for case studies and best practices, it is again a static page, and it is I think removed from production site as well. Now I will go into members corner. These all pages are static, so we need to follow the same steps that we did for editing the about us page, and those steps will work over here as well. Going into press releases. So I think press releases, this is the news. So I told you that how news are created, and once you create a news, they will be listed over here. And if I go into press releases, they are static pages. This is also removed from production side. So this is again a static page. I think I described this event page. I think I described that how events are created.
Feature.
And this links, this is removed from production side. I think, yeah, okay, it is on.
Feature.
So this page will show all the content which are marked as featured. Yeah. So this is about the all the menus and some menus and content. How can you edit a content? I anything else that I need to show?
Okay.
I'm sorry. Okay, so this is about those things that I wanted to show on it. That,
okay, so what can you do?
Okay.